In this video, we're going to focus on one of the most important definitions in topology, and that is metrisation. We say that a topological space is metrisable if there exists a metric that induces the topology on X. So we have X with a topology, and if I can find a metric T such that the basis, that is balls with center in X and some radius R, if this basis induces the same topology that we had originally in the space, then we say that this topological space is metrisable. It is a desirable property for a space to be metrisable because it is a very comfortable basis to work with. We're just working with elements in the space, a radius, and a metric that is already defined. And for this, we will see later on, we need a lot of concepts for this, but we will see a theorem called Udison's metrisation theorem. This theorem actually uses Udison's lemma, which is also extremely important, both in topology and in analysis. So what we will do in this video is prove that a particular space that we have been working with is metrisable. And that space is R omega with the product topology. In our last video, we defined a new topology, the uniform one, from a metric. So obviously, metric spaces induce a topology, and that topology is metrisable. But now, given this topological space, for example, is there a metric such that induces the product topology? The answer is not trivial, but there is a metric, and the metric is defined like this for X and Y elements in R omega. We define it as the supremum of the bounded matrix in each coordinate divided by the index. So this is overall the natural numbers, and you can see that it's very similar to the uniform metric. So the objective will be to prove that the product topology is equal to the topology induced by this metric. Let's start by proving the inclusion that the metric topology is a subset of the product topology. For this, we will be using, as always, the lemma that we saw in the video about bases, which said that we had to take an element in the product space, a neighborhood of that element in the smaller topology, in this case, in the topology induced by the metric, and we want to prove that there exists some set in the product topology such that X is an element of B and B a subset of U. So this will be our objective, finding an element in the product topology such that this happens. So if U is an element in the topology induced by this metric, then we know that we will be able to find some ball with this metric contained in U, because U will just be the union or intersections of elements in the basis, and the basis is formed by the balls formed with the metric. Just take some radius epsilon such that the ball with center in X and radius epsilon is contained in U, and this ball is obviously constructed with the metric T. Now, given that this epsilon is fixed, we will take a natural number n such that 1 over n is smaller than epsilon. And you may not understand this, but it will make sense in a minute. So with this n, we will define a set P as the first coordinate of X minus epsilon, the first coordinate of X plus epsilon. So just the usual interval in the real numbers, the product of this with the same but in the second coordinate, and so on. We continue with this product until we reach the nth coordinate, so xn minus epsilon, xn plus epsilon, and then for all the rest we will just add products with the real numbers. So obviously, B is an element in the product topology. This is trivial because just a finite amount of intervals in the element B are not the real numbers, and then all the rest, all the infinite orders, are the real numbers. So now what we have to see is that actually what we want is satisfied. So let's see that X is an element in B and B is a subset of U. That X is an element in B is also trivial because obviously XI is on each of these intervals for I from 1 to n, and the rest are all the real numbers, so obviously all the coordinates of X will be in there. And so all we have to prove is this inclusion. For this, let's just take an element Y in B and prove that Y is also an element in U. Actually, what we are going to prove is that B is a subset of this ball, which is also a subset of U, so we're still on the same page, given Y and B. To prove that Y is an element in this ball, we will have to prove that the distance between X and Y is smaller than epsilon. So let's remember what this distance is. It is the supremum of the bounded distances on each coordinate divided by the index for all the natural numbers. So now what happens when n is greater than or equal to this number n we found? Remember that 1 over n is smaller than epsilon. And so, when we are in this situation, we have that the bounded distance of each coordinate over n is going to be less than or equal to 1 over n. And so, this distance will be bounded by not a supremum, because we have removed an infinite amount of these distances, but a maximum of all the other distances that I'm not considering here. So the distance bounded of x1, y1 divided by 1, the second one, and so on, up to the ends. And then for all the rest, just take 1 over n. This is greater than or equal to, is not unequal. But we don't need the equal, because all we want to prove is that this distance is smaller than epsilon. So what happens is that if y is an element in B, then because of the form that our set B has, this maximum is smaller than epsilon, because all of these are going to be smaller than epsilon, because each coordinate of y is in this interval. But then 1 over n is also here smaller than epsilon. So if all these elements are smaller than epsilon, and so is 1 over n, we have that the maximum is going to be smaller than epsilon. Immediately the distance between x and y is smaller than epsilon, and this means that y is an element in the D-ball with center in X and radius epsilon. So then we have that X is an element in B, B is a subset of this set, and this set we already proved that was a subset of U. So that proves this inclusion. The topology induced by the metric D is coarser than the product topology in our omega. Now we have to prove the reverse inclusion, that the product topology is a subset of the topology induced by the metric. For this, we will do something very similar to what we did when we proved that the product topology was coarser than the uniform topology. Again, using the lemma, let's take an element, a neighborhood of that element in the product topology. So because U is in the product topology, we know that U is going to be a product of UN, where UN is a subset of R, an open subset, for n equal n I, and I between 1 and m, for a finite amount of indexes, these sets are open subsets of the real line, and un is equal to the real numbers for n different than n is. So for all the rest, these sets are all the real line. Well, like before, what we want now is to find an epsilon such that x is an element in now the table, which is an element in the basis of the metric topology, with center in x and radius epsilon, and this ball subset of u. This is what we want to prove. So we actually want to find this epsilon, similar to what we did in our previous videos. Given that all these sets are open, then we know that there exists epsilon I, so for each one of these, such that the interval x and I minus epsilon I, x and I plus epsilon I, is a subset of u and I. And this, again, is just for a finite amount of indexes. So what we can do is take epsilon to be the minimum between epsilon I divided by the corresponding index n sub I, and this is for I from 1 up to m. So this is just a finite amount of positive numbers divided by their indexes. We take the infimum and we call this number epsilon. Now let's prove that x is an element in the D-ball with center in x and radius epsilon, and this ball is a subset of u. This first inclusion is obviously trivial, because I'm even considering the center x, but we have to prove this inclusion. And for this, let's take y an element in the ball. So this means that the distance between x and y is less than epsilon. But this distance, let's remember what it was, is the supremum of the bounded distance in each coordinate divided by the index. So if this is smaller than epsilon, then that means that each of these divided by the index is going to be smaller than epsilon. And in particular, it will happen for the indexes n sub I, so mi bar of x n I and y n I, so those indexes for which the sets u are not the real numbers, divided by the index is also smaller than epsilon. But epsilon was the minimum of this element, so epsilon is smaller than epsilon I over n I. And so this proves that each of those coordinates y and I is in this interval, and so is a subset of u and I. And for all the other indexes, well, these sets were all the real numbers, so obviously yn is going to be a real number, so it's going to be in u sub n. And so we have that y is an element in u, and then x is in this ball, and this ball is a subset of u, which is exactly what we had to prove to show that the product topology is coarser than the topology induced by this metric D. And so we have proven this equality, and like this we know that R omega with the product topology is metrizable. If you want to support the channel, you can do so in different ways. You can either donate or become a member on Ko-fi to get exclusive access to content. If you want, in addition to that exclusive content, merchandise, then you can become a member on Patreon, Or if all you want is the merchandise, then you can buy t-shirts or other stuff in our store.